morning, Brendan. Thanks for coming down.
Pleasure. Beautiful morning, isn't it? Lovely.
Yeah, you've done well. You've been a member for quite some time now. What attracts you to the Bright Paths and keeps you coming back?
Well, initially it was... Initially, I had a really bad back, 316, and facet joint issues. And at work, whilst I've got an incredible gym, I've got all the toys and all the equipment you can imagine, I didn't want to go and embarrass myself by doing a bit of work. And that was the advice I got from physio and doctors. I need to start working on the core, not like sitting, letting you go. And I've never actually joined a gym. I've never been a gym member in my life. And in fact, it was Danny Frawley, God bless him, that suggested I should come down here. And so I started using the gym. I thought it'd be nice to have a bit of a swim afterwards, and then I just duck at it through winter, and so that was the initial motive. But then it was just the community, you know. It's a bit like I just said, the same people all the time, and everyone's trips down, everyone's the same, young, old, it doesn't matter what you do, surgeon, trading, it's a great snapshot of Australia.
Yeah, it is. That's what brings us together. Yeah. Now, little birdie told me you used to play guitar in a band.
Very poorly. Very poorly. No, it's been beaten up over the years, but I come from a musical family, from a big family. My mother was a piano teacher, but I'd never played music. I was interested in learning music. It was for me, Graham Tassie, it was footy, cricket, surfing, that was it. But I got glandular fever in my early 20s when I came over to play football. And I had, but it was pretty bad actually, so a good 5-6 months where I was just sort of homebound and taught myself guitar. That's all. I've just had a bit of an ear for music or an aptitude. I was self-taught and ended up in a bit of a footy band of different sports put together. We were on Channel 9 a couple of times, which was the precursor to the footy show Player Review. All called Trial by Video, and met some good musicians, but I was still out.
Good times, huh?
Good times. Good times. We actually had a residency at a nightclub in the city on Sunday nights called The Tunnel, which some members here might have a few skeletons in the closet of The Tunnel. But we had a little trip to Perth, which was fun as well, but it was a bit of a...
Yeah, right. In your role as CEO of the Richmond Football Club, how's that evolved over the 10 or 11 years that you've been in that role?
Significantly. When I started at Richmond, it was the club wasn't in a great way, but I had a board that sort of pointed me and provided me with a pretty bad, strong mandate to change things. And that's what it was. It weren't performing as well as we could have been off the field and on the field. And so it was a time of great change and energy. Maybe in the future, building a business model at a time when clubs are going to increase the commercial money really mattered. So we had to really fire up that part of that club. And it became, over that first 3 to 5 years, and it became sort of iterative and became, got the basics, the administration, the alignment, the business. Now we've just got to make sure everyone's on the same page and everyone's sort of playing their role and fulfilling that mission and purpose. And as a leader now, my job is to sort of step back, create the space for others to really step up into lead and take responsibility for the business. And I think we've done an almighty job.
Given the current crisis, the football clubs are a business like any other business, like this business. It's been shut down overnight. How are you managing the impact of that?
Oh, look, it's significant. It's unprecedented. We've never experienced anything like this in our lifetime, and hopefully we never will again. Nothing's guaranteed. But look, it's a huge shock to our business, the whole psyche of our business. I feel that's a big, it's the biggest sport in the country, many measures. It's the biggest sport in media property. It's a strong competition, but overnight, the flick of a switch, the revenue stops. We are in the business of mass gathering. So when our business model is just broken, it brings enormous pressure on the business. So all we've been trying to do is is firstly to manage your cost, because that's all we can do at the moment. And that's required some really, really hard decisions and around our people and our programs in the short to medium term. But bearing in mind our people, the biggest part of our business, it's a GM or football club, it's like a family. So you really see the person impacted on those decisions. So we try to be really empathetic and sensitive, but we need to get our club through this period, make some of these hard decisions now, so the club can thrive for another 10 years. That's not guaranteed for some clubs.
Given the crisis has made a lot of us evaluate what's important to us, I get a sense that people really appreciate their football clubs and the actual activity of going, watching and supporting. Is there a chance or a belief that possibly the bounce back will actually grow the club more as a result of revealing people's priorities and the importance of football in their lives?
Yeah, I think so. What this does, periods like this, it does out of necessity, caution, reflect on the things and what I think is really important in our business. Obviously, critical right now, we need to focus on it. Same with life. And so I think we've all sat back, we've all reflected and some of the things that really matter. You know, what does really matter in life? You know, this appetite for consumption, just buying stuff, crap. But I think what really matters is having a real, a strong purpose in life, a purposeful life, a virtuous life. The human connection is really important. The sense and strength of community, because we felt that being so isolated. And I think sport is a really important part of that. It's community building, it's community strengthening. Now, clearly, AFL is a big part of that. As an elite sport, but sport. So I think, and it's been taken, it's such an important part of our social fabric, taken for granted, and it's taken away. You realise you know, it's a bit like I get up in the morning and I spend just about my entire day on Zoom, as we all do on video conferencing. And I think the first week or two, so I thought, well, this is a bit of a morning, and maybe this is going to be an important part of the mix into how we work in the future. But then you realise, I get to the end of the day, I'm exhausted.
Yeah.
What I've learned is you actually draw energy off people. So when you're sitting at work at meetings and discussing ideas and bouncing off, you're sucking up the creativity and energy. The energy you don't get when you're talking to a computer screen.
Yeah.
So that connection.
Yeah, right. Are you still managing to get some fitness and well-being into your own day at the minute?
Well, I am, Matty. I'll be doing a lot better when we open up here. But no, I am. Look, that's a really important part. That's just a thing I have to tick off for my own, not just my physical well-being, but my mental well-being. I mentioned my back right at the start, but it is more mental. So I've been getting down to the Denby Beach with a few of the crew down there and jumping out, building home, jumping in a hot shower. So I'm doing that. I'm just got my own little hole at home, gym, with some rubber bands on my shoulders, just a bit of bouncing around in the backyard, doing a bit with my kids. Actually, as well, so I guess I'm here after school. I'm just leaving homeschool and go and have a kegel for you, go run a few laps. It's actually too, so I'm doing as good as I can.
Yeah. Thanks for sharing your time this morning. I know you're obviously busy at this time, and